Some see him as the streetcar savior, others as a symbol of misplaced spending priorities. Tonight, Cincinnati is moving ahead with a plan to spend six figures to bring in an experienced project manager. WLWT News 5's John London live now with a look at the tug of war over the new hire. John.
Yeah, not just any new hire, Mike. This is the go-to guy for the Banks project, the guru of the Fort Washington Way remake from years ago. But the fight is not over who, it's about what, namely the star-crossed streetcar.
Depending on where you sit, today's streetcar budget nugget is either gold.
This is not taking resources from the general fund.
Or greed.
I do not believe that, John.
Feeling the weight of larger than expected construction bids, City Manager Milton Dahoney is mining what he sees as gold, a project manager with impeccable credentials. That would be John Dietrich, former guiding hand of the Fort Washington Way renovation, current project manager for the Banks. No one has a problem with the person, it's the price that comes with it, anywhere from $140,000 to $188,000.
But talk about bad timing.
To the head of the police union, it looks bad to create a new position and make it among the top five most compensated in all of city government at a time when safety layoffs are being considered. The manager and streetcar supporters emphasize the money will come from the project itself, not from the general fund.
They're spending money. They're constantly spending money.
But to streetcar skeptics, it's like the money version of Where's Waldo?
When you're cash flowing grants, those dollars are coming out of all funds, right? You're cash flowing this project. Number two, no one knows whether 5 years from now where this guy is going to be getting paid from.
Democrat Lori Quinlivan says her confidence has been bolstered, seeing Dietrich as the linchpin to rein in the bids. She says it's what Paul Brown Stadium lacked. Result, cost overruns. It's what Great American Ballpark had. Result, on time and under budget. Dietrich hasn't been hired yet, but in a split 5-4 vote, council has changed an ordinance to allow it to happen. He would start getting into the weeds of those oversized bids, something the city's been quiet about for weeks.
We haven't heard anything since then. Give me an answer to that question and then we'll have a conversation. This sort of approach of ready, fire, aim is not what citizens are looking for.
Well, Mike, until that DNA test...
Streetcar backers saying this is certainly the guy, wherever you fall on the merits of the project, that can bring this project in on budget. He has talked with the city. He's not officially on board yet. Today was the first step. Live at City Hall, John London, WLWT News 5.
And John, the city had to pass this ordinance that you just mentioned a few seconds ago because Dietrich is a retired city worker drawing a pension. So they actually had to remove the ban, I guess, on double dipping. What impact will this have long term and on current employees who are now eligible to collect a salary and a pension?
Mike, there are certainly some who will see this as precedent. There are others, though, who say, well, you know, despite the fact that a five-year-old city law was changed today, manager Milton Dahoney recognizes that time is of the essence here and that this guy is the right fit for the project and right in our backyard.
All right, John London, live for us tonight. Thank you very much.